For most, the idea of democracy in China is one that seems highly unlikely, if not impossible. Well, I'm here today to challenge that assumption. So let me take you back to the year 1966, 17 years after Communist Party Chairman Mao Zedong established the People's Republic of China, and 4 years after the end of the Great Leap Forward, which ultimately ended in the tragic loss of 30 to 50 million lives. So now it's 1966, and Mao, trying to regain his once good reputation, institutes the Cultural Revolution. But it's at this point that we see him begin to remove those from power with dissenting opinions and persecute those who express any discontent with him and the Communist Party. So at this point, you're probably asking yourself, how could a country with this sort of history ever transition to democracy? Well, now it's 1977, and with the death of Mao and the consequent end of the Cultural Revolution, Deng Xiaoping and the new Chinese leadership institute a series of reforms to gradually dismantle these Maoist policies. And this is where things begin to get interesting, because since these reforms began, China has experienced steady and positive GDP growth. Urban population growth has also steadily increased, going from about 18% in 1978 to about 56% in 2015. In terms of education, the adult literacy rates in China have gone from about 66% in 1982 to about 96% in 2015. And these developments have substantially affected the attitudes of the Chinese people, especially those who were born into the improved economic conditions, leading scholars to expect that newer generations will be more pro-democratic than older ones. And with this growing social pressure, the Chinese government has responded with gradual capitalistic and democratic innovations. These include economic reforms, like the opening of markets and the reducing of trade barriers, as well as political reforms, like the abolition of life tenure for leaders, the use of inter-party democracy, and the implementation of village elections nationally. Now, with the strength and longevity of China's one-party regime, it's impossible to predict if the country will ever fully democratize, or how long it would even take for the government to do so. However, beneath China's seemingly rigid political structure, the social infrastructure for democratization is emerging and has progressed further than most observers realize. And while it may not have been Mao's plan for his legacy to eventually lead to the Chinese people becoming more and more pro-democratic, it's almost certain that we will continue to see these innovations develop throughout the country. After all, democracy is a process, not an end state. And as is often the case, the journey is more important than the destination. Thank you.